Welcome to Research 601, Module 5. In this module, we're going to look at the last installment of our SLP assignment. And in this one, we're going to do a little post hoc analysis to test some other relationships. Mainly, we're looking at some mediation and moderation, looking at moderation first. In last module, we finished testing our hypothesis, and it was supported. But now we're going to look a little deeper. The first thing I want to look at is our demographics. We had two demographics, age and gender, and I want to see if they had an interaction effect with our dependent variable. And to do that, we're going to test for moderation. The second thing we're going to do after that is we're going to look at job satisfaction and organizational behavior and see if there's any mediation effect going on there. So let's start with moderation. We're looking at age and gender. So the first thing I want to do is I just want to do a linear regression. We're going to leave engagement behavior as our dependent variable. We're going to stick age and gender in. Let's just run that and see what we get. Okay. With age and gender, we see neither one is significant. They're both around the 0.3 range in significance. So there's no effect of either age or gender on our dependent variable. But now I want to look and I want to see, is there any moderation going on there? And so we'll test for that. When we're testing for moderation, the first thing we want to do is we have to create a moderator variable. And that moderator is the product of our two independent variables, our independent variable and our moderator, which we're not designating either one as moderator at this point, moderating variable at this point. But the first thing we have to do is we have to standardize or centralize our variables, one or the other. We're going to standardize them. And to do that, it's very easy. We're going to descriptive statistics. And we're going to click that Save as Standardized Variables block. Let's make all these go away. And let's stick age and gender in. And OK. Now we've standardized our variables. Where we see that at is out here. Z age and Z gender, those are both standardized variables. Now we're going to create our moderator. And we're going to create this variable. And very simply, let's just name it moderator. And the label will just say that is age times gender. Because that's what basically we're doing. Actually, we're doing Z age, standardized age times the standardized gender. And all we're doing here is Z age times Z gender. Pretty easy. Okay, and that is our moderator variable out here. Now we're going to run our regression analysis again, just like before. Linear regression, and we're going to add our new variable, which is our moderator variable, Z age times Z gender. Okay, and see what we have. Okay, when we run all three together, still nothing significant. If I look up here, I can see that when we ran it before, with just age and gender, that is here. Okay, our R squared was practically nothing, 0.006. If I come down to our latest one, our R squared, 0.013, a little bit higher, but not enough to really say that there's any interaction at all. If the moderator had become significant, or if the introduction of the moderator had caused either of the other ones to become significant, then we would look a little bit deeper and see exactly what was going on. We can see here that there's no moderation effect happening in this situation. The next one to do is look and see if we have any mediation. And this is our model here. We're hypothesizing that job satisfaction mediates the relationship between organizational commitment and engagement behavior. And basically what we're saying there is that those with high job satisfaction may be less engaged than those with moderate job satisfaction or low job satisfaction. And so the relationship between organizational commitment and engagement behavior may be mediated by job satisfaction. And that's what we want to test. And that's fairly easy to test. First, we've already tested our relationship with the construct, but we haven't done it with the underlying variables. So let's go to linear regression. And the first thing we're going to look at is the relationship, because if you remember from your assignments, there's three conditions that must be met. The first is that your independent variable, or say commitment, well, let's get rid of these other ones. Is related to your dependent variable, which is engagement behavior. So we'll run that first. And what we see here is that it is significant at the p less than 0.001 level. Our beta is 0.3, and it explains about 17% of the variance. So it is significant. That part is met. The independent variable is related to the dependent variable. Let's see if the independent variable is related to the moderator, or the mediator rather. So here, we'll take engagement behavior out, and we're going to put job satisfaction in. And we see that, yes, it is significant. 0.362 is our beta, and it explains about 26% of the variance. Organization commitment explains about 60% of the variance in job satisfaction. So the last test we need to run, the last condition before we can test for mediation, is the mediator job satisfaction related to the dependent variable engagement behavior. And so we'll check that, and we see that, yes, job satisfaction is related to engagement behavior at the p less than 0.001 level. The beta is 0.535, and it explains 26% of the variance. And so now we're ready to see the test for mediation, since we know that all of our requirements are met. And to do that, we've already got engagement behavior as the dependent variable. We've got our moderator as one variable we're testing. The other variable we're testing is organizational commitment. So that's our two variables, our mediator, and we're testing for their effect on our dependent variable. We run that analysis, and we see that the model is significant. We see that organizational commitment is significant, and job satisfaction is significant. We explain around 30% of the variance in engagement behavior. If we look at the strength of the commitment, we see that our value of job satisfaction is 0.428, where organization commitment has dropped to 0.152. Let's go back and look at that before. When we ran organization commitment by itself, it only explained 25% of the variance with a 0.36 beta. In our final model, the beta is only 0.152. The model actually explains more than by itself, but it's dropped substantially, even though it's still significant. So what we have, here's how you interpret that. Say if job satisfaction was significant and organizational behavior became non-significant, okay? Then we can say that job satisfaction fully mediated organizational commitment. It didn't happen. What we can say here is that job satisfaction partially mediated it, because when we introduced job satisfaction to the model, the effect of organizational commitment really dropped off substantially. And if I look at the relationship of job satisfaction on, we explained 26% with just job satisfaction, right? When I introduce all three, we only explain 29%. So job satisfaction is partially mediating the effect of relational commitment on engagement behavior. So that's our effect, partial mediation. You can also run a Sobel's test, and basically you go to an online calculator, and what you're going to input there is the beta and the standard error. That's what you're using. And you can actually get a mediation test statistic. But this is how you do the mediation using multiple linear regression. And that's it. What you'll want to do next is bring all of your information into module 5 into your SLP, write it up, but this time include everything from the previous modules also, and basically what you'll have is a template for chapter 4 of your dissertation if you were testing using SPSS. In later courses, you'll go through some other tools that you can use to test your models, structural equation modeling using AMOS or partial least squares, but this is how you would do it with SPSS. Thank you, and I hope you've enjoyed this. Go back in. I encourage you to go back in periodically because it's a long time between now. You're moving into your concentration courses. You'll come out of your concentration courses and then back into statistics. So over these next few courses, I would encourage you to go in and just play around with this a little bit just to keep fresh on how to do the processes. When you move into the other tools, we call them different things. We call it a measurement model when we're doing structural equation modeling, instead of calling it test for validity and reliability. And instead of testing our hypotheses with regression, we're going to test for our hypotheses using our structural model. But really, it's the same steps that you're going to be going through. It's just using a different tool, so we call it something different. And so to be better prepared for that, I would encourage you to stay familiar with this process, so that'll be in the back of your mind as you move into the next one. And I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.